वेलकम लर्नर्स, आई एम माधुरी हुड्डा फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एजुकेशन, महर्षि दयानंद यूनिवर्सिटी, रोहतक. एज वी ऑल नो द टीचिंग लर्निंग प्रोसेस इज इवॉल्विंग कॉन्टिन्यूअसली एंड वी एज टीचर्स आर टू फेस सो मेनी चैलेंजेस इनसाइड द क्लासरूम एंड आउटसाइड द क्लासरूम एज वेल. एंड इन ऑर्डर टू कोप विद दीज चैलेंजेस एंड टू ब्रिंग क्वालिटी इन एजुकेशन, कॉन्टिन्यूअस प्रोफेशनल डेवलपमेंट ऑफ ए साइंस टीचर इज नेसेसरी. फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस प्रोफेशनल डेवलपमेंट ऑफ ए साइंस टीचर इन डिटेल. बिफोर वी स्टार्ट डिस्कसिंग दिस कंसेप्ट, लेट अस डिस्कस सम बेसिक टर्म्स लाइक प्रोफेशन, प्रोफेशनल डेवलपमेंट, टू हैव सफिशियंट अंडरस्टैंडिंग अबाउट आवर मेन थीम. अंडर दिस मेन कंसेप्ट वील एबल टू डिस्कस टीचिंग एज ए प्रोफेशन एंड टीचिंग ऑफ साइंस एंड चैलेंजेस, द नीड एंड रेलेवेंस ऑफ प्रोफेशनल डेवलपमेंट ऑफ साइंस टीचर्स. सो लेट अस स्टार्ट आवर थीम इन डिटेल. Many a times we hear the terms like job, occupation and profession. And all these terms, though seem to have the same meaning, but differ in meaning and the context as well. The common meaning is to put our services, that is knowledge, skills and experience, to others like a group or community in a formal or informal way. Profession is the formalization or institutionalization of these services and based upon some specific standards. If we define profession, profession is a type of ideology based on some specific standards aimed at providing skilled services in terms of education, knowledge, guidance and training, etc. to an individual or a group or some community in a more formal way, with or without payment. Every profession has some professional standards like accountability, honesty, dedication and sincerity, integrity, loyalty, objectivity, conformity with norms and standards, and transparency. We may take examples of profession like teaching, accountancy, engineering, and law. All these are type of professions. So when we say teaching is a profession, it is always admired and stated that the teachers are the backbone of any society or nation, and teaching is the mother of all the professions. It is only the teachers and the quality of teaching that will lead to society in the direction and development and prosperity. The holy task of developing the young aspiring minds into fully balanced and harmonious personalities and responsible citizens of tomorrow lies on the shoulder of teacher. Teaching as profession, though, has all the required standards and qualities of a profession, but it differs from other professions in some aspects. A teacher has some qualities which are very specific, which make him quite different from other professionals, which may be, first is depth and up-to-date knowledge of his subject area. Second, we can say the skills of teaching, like formal teaching, which programs like JBT and BEd provide. Third is knowledge of different teaching methods and strategies. Sound knowledge of different stages of development of his learners, like physical development, emotional development, intellectual development and social development, such type of developments. And the next is well-balanced personality with broad outlook. Teacher is to have the virtues like tolerance, patience, open-mindedness, flexibility, supportive and democratic, etc. He should have good interpersonal and intrapersonal skills as well. Alertness and eagerness to learn anytime and up-to-date his knowledge and skills regularly. Now with this knowledge of the term profession and discussing the uniqueness of teaching as a profession, let us move one step forward toward the main theme, that is professional development of science teacher, by focusing in brief on the topic science teaching and the challenges. There are new innovations and inventions in technology every year, and all the walks of life have been revolutionized by these inventions. We come across many technological devices or instruments in our everyday life. The operation of these gadgets requires specific skills and knowledge of science. In this era of science, it becomes very important to educate and train our young generations with scientific knowledge and skills and help them to attain scientific temper. It is only possible through the teaching of science at various levels of education by the well-qualified and skillful science teachers. And the friends, see, the present picture of teaching science as a subject is not very satisfactory in our country, where many students, particularly at school level, are not able to define the basic terms of science. They are also not able to enjoy and appreciate many simple and interesting activities which are given in notebooks and textbooks. Like the NCERT textbook, you may find some sort of activities. Students don't enjoy those activities. Moreover, they are devoid of this joy of studying science. And due to lack of basic infrastructure facilities like laboratory, instruments, ventilation and light facility, the science teaching is not achieving its objectives adequately. Lack of trained and skillful teachers is also a factor for poor science teaching. Lack of professional development of science teacher is also responsible. Use of poor teaching methods, which have become obsolete now, teachers are still using those methods. Aversion to use of technology in classroom by the classroom. Although teachers are aware, but still they are reluctant to use technology in the classrooms. In order to overcome all these problems in teaching science, it needs specific knowledge of teaching methods and skills, unlike other subjects like laboratory method, heuristic approach, inductive and deductive method, playway method, project method, learning by doing. All such type of methods need to be equipped for the teachers. It is very clear that teaching science is not an easy job. Rather, it requires well-trained teachers with the knowledge of effective use of technology in teaching learning process and apart from the knowledge of the methods. It requires the professional development of a science teacher, which we are discussing. When we say professional development of a teacher, the expansion, refinement and maintenance of professional traits and qualities, including the knowledge, skills, experience, ethics, all need to be included in professional development. It is not a ready-made thing, rather it is a continuous process requiring efforts and energy on the part of the professionals. Here, we may throw a light on the definition given by Day in 1999, the process by which teachers review, renew and extend their commitment as change agents and by which they acquire and develop critically the knowledge, skills, planning and practice through each phase of their teaching lives. We can have another definition by OECD in 2010. Teachers' professional development is the body of systematic activities to prepare teachers for their job, including initial training, induction courses, in-service training and continuous professional development within school settings. Now, let us discuss the need of professional development. With the fast-changing and growing educational needs and problems of modern learners, specifically in science, poses many challenges before the teachers. What they have learned 10 or 15 years ago, teachers are still using those obsolete methods, those obsolete knowledge and the skills. Now, it has become very pertinent to update the knowledge and the skills which they have learned many years ago. Introduction of NCF, National Curriculum Framework, in 2005 has also brought drastic changes in teaching learning process and roles of teachers. Catering to needs of a wide variety of learners in an inclusive classroom also put demands for professional development of teachers. Let me have a brief view on significance of professional development of science teachers, which is very pertinent to discuss over here. First is extension of subject knowledge domain. Second is acquisition of new and fresh knowledge. Third, we can say enhancement of professional competencies among teachers, which is very well required for the new changing work world. Third is knowledge of new theories and inventions in science all over the world. Next is development of new beliefs and attitude towards science. Knowledge of new teaching methods, pedagogy and skills, which are continuously being updated by the result of researches. Improvement and enhancement in technological skills like use of ICT, learning classroom management, awareness of new policies, schemes, initiatives in science education, and in the last, knowledge of addressing diversities in classroom. Dear learners, till now we have discussed the need and significance of professional development of science teachers. Now in the second section, we'll discuss and focus on various programs for their professional development in our country to ensure the continuous growth of our science teachers. Program for professional development of science teacher can be broadly classified in three categories. First is pre-service training programs. Second is in-service training programs. Third is individualized programs by the use of ICT. When we say pre-service training programs, we can say these programs are basically aimed at educating teachers before they enter into the profession of teaching. It mainly focuses at the preparation of teachers equipped with certain personality traits, attitudes, aptitude, and qualities which are essential for being a teacher. Pre-service training includes the development of some aspects which are very crucial for the professional development of teacher. First is development of personality traits, attitude, aptitude, required insight in the classroom, knowledge of teaching methodology and various skills and strategies. Third is various aspects of education like philosophical, sociological and psychological aspects. Next is knowledge of different stages of development of learner, physical, intellectual, emotional and social development. Aspects of curriculum development, use of technology in teaching learning process. All the pre-service training programs can be classified into some levels. First is nursery teacher training, NTT. This training aims at preparing teachers for teaching students of pre-primary to nursery classes. The eligibility to enter this course is 10 plus 2. Earlier it used to be called as intermediate. When we call the second level, it is primary teacher training institute. These institutes prepare the teachers for teaching children of primary level, basically including classes from 1st to 5th. It is generally known as junior basic training, JBT, commonly known as JBT. The requirement for this course is 10 plus 2. It's a very popular program throughout the country and there are many institutes offering this program. Next level is colleges of education for secondary teachers. It prepares teachers for teaching students at middle, secondary and higher secondary level. It's a 2-year course and offers a degree of education to teachers. Eligibility for this course is BA, BSc or MA, MSc with 50% marks for general category students. Next is regional colleges of education. Regional colleges were set up in 1963 by the government of India with the intent of qualitative improvement of school education through innovative pre-service and in-service teacher education programs, and relevant research, development and extension activities are also supported in these centers. Next is institutes for postgraduate teacher education. This includes PG classes. And it includes MA in education, which is a 2-year course, Masters in education, MEd, which is also a 2-year course, and postgraduate diplomas in education. Next level is after pre-service education, we can say in-service training programs. According to Lawrence, in-service education is the education a teacher receives after he has entered to teaching profession and after he has completed his education in a teacher's college. It includes all the programs, educational, social and others, in which the teacher takes a virtual part. All the extra education which he receives at different institutions by way of refresher and other professional courses and travels and visits for the courses which he undertakes. Having entered the teaching profession with pre-service training is not alone sufficient, but continuous expansion and improvement of knowledge and skills to meet the demands of fast-changing education system, it is also equally important. These include the following programs, the seminars. All the participants collaborate towards the solution of a problem related to science or technology. Under the guidance of experts, problem is collectively discussed and conclusions are provided and submitted to the organizers for further publications. Refresher courses. It aims at refreshing the knowledge and skills of science teachers by discussing new theories and technological inventions. New attitude and beliefs are instilled among the teachers by some resource persons in the field of science and technologies. Conferences, papers are presented by the teachers before the experts in the conference on some topic of science which has some practical importance. Conclusions are given by the president after presentations of all the participant teachers. Another may be the study groups of teachers with same subject and having common interest are formed and guided by some experts for discussion over the problems and issues related to their field of study. Teachers continue thinking, studying and discussing the problem and finally reach a solution. Some other sources may be the experimental schools, corresponding courses, educational tours, TV or radio programs. Using ICT, using internet technology, let us see and discuss in brief some programs for professional development of science teachers. First, we can say MOOCs, which is very popular nowadays. What is MOOCs? MOOCs are massive open online courses, which gives easy and anytime access to educational material as per the needs and requirement free of cost. Government of India has taken some initiatives recently in the form of SWAM, SWAM Prabha, NEPTEL, etc. Teachers can update their knowledge by accessing freely available material or by enrolling in some courses of their interest. And these are free of cost and it's a great platform for the professional development of teachers. Teachers can use ICT for the development of their self, their personal as well as professional development. Next is OERs. What are OERs? OERs are open educational resources which are freely available, online educational content including text, articles, lesson plans, techniques, tools of learning, tools of assessment, teacher made designs, laboratory manuals, text, reference book, pictorial quizzes and many more resources. They are free of cost, they are available in the form of audio, video forms, pictures, graphs, wide variety and wide range of open educational resources are available free of cost and teachers can use them with the use of ICT and these are also free of cost. Next is Wikipedia. It's a free online encyclopedia created and edited by a large number of volunteers over the globe. It may be utilized for updating the knowledge of some terms and concepts of science. Social groups. It is also a great platform for professional development of teachers. The most common and most popular is Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, LinkedIn, WhatsApp, etc. Most of the programs and most of the social platforms we use, but these can also be used for our professional development. These also help teachers to become aware of recent events and discoveries in the field of science. Many things including classroom management, teaching methods can be shared with other professionals in the same field. Next is e-conferences and webinars. Earlier we discussed the seminars. These are little different. It includes the seminars or conferences over the internet, which can also be utilized for professional development of science teachers. Dear learners, today we have discussed some concepts related to professional development of a science teacher. These were teaching, teaching profession, what is the need of professional development of science teachers, what was the significance of development of science teacher, and then we discussed in detail the various levels of professional development of science teacher, like pre-service teacher training programs, in-service teacher training programs, and professional development of science teacher by themselves with the use of ICT. Friends, I hope you have enjoyed today's learning session. With best wishes for further learning. Thank you.